Tom and Jackie were lagging behind the class, about 50 yards behind even Fat Billy Bloomquist, huffing and sweating in miserable effort to keep up. This corner of southern Oregon was dense with redwoods and massive pines, mingling with oaks and cedars and junipers, an eternal war between Canadian conifers and Californian acorn oaks and smaller scrub oaks. The afternoon sun was filtering through the foliage in a pleasant, dreamlike fashion. Jackie took a beat-up G.I. Joe from his jeans pocket and whacked its head against an old stump jutting out into the trail. "Is that a nighthawk?" Tom asked. "Nope," Jackie said. "Hillary Vimps." Tom laughed. He was pretty sure it was Nighthawk, but it figured Jackie had his own weird name for it. He called lots of stuff by weird names he either made up himself or heard somewhere. Tom saw something skitter through the dense undergrowth of prickly scrub oaks and poison ivy. Probably a rat or a frog, he thought. He was about to point it out to Jackie, his friend, but Jackie wore thick, convex glasses, which made his eyes look like misshapen frogs' eyes, goggling, magnified by the lenses in two big green eggs. Besides, the thing had gone underneath a pile of kudzu sprouting from a mossy clefted acorn oak, a dozen yards off the trail. Jackie had stopped walking and stood peering after the thing which had hidden in the mossy ferny growth to their right. He was shielding his lensed eyes from the late afternoon sun slanting in warm orange beams through the tall pine's boughs. He'd apparently heard something. It occurred to Tom, who had 20/20 vision, that Jackie had heard the thing skitter away from the trail, though he'd failed to see any movement. While Tom hadn't heard a thing, except the crows croaking distantly, and the nearer drone of Mr. Crabtree, their guide, monologuing about the different types of legends which abounded in the area. The elusive Sasquatch, the dreaded Wendigo, and even a sort of poison skin fairy which haunted these hillsides and could bend men's minds. It seemed unlikely that Jackie's ears were any better, physically, than his own. No, it must be that Jackie listened more, or heard more. Or both. Jackie was squinting with a look of fierce curiosity, almost confusion, now starting to walk off the trail, into the woods. His sneakers made a soft crunch and crackle as he stepped on twigs hidden in the thick fall of last year's dead pine needles, faded to a dull copper brown by a thousand hours of sunlight. Small patches of bleached toadstool stood about. Tom followed Jackie, quickly catching up. Jackie was already squatting beside the kudzu overgrown oak, and he now reached in and lifted up the big, bending clump which had made the dense little pocket of shadow into which the creature had run for cover. A recent rain, which had soaked the ground deep, had still left small pockets of moisture here in the deeper shadows, and he could feel the ground smooshing gently beneath the straw-like matting of the moist patches of pine needles. Tom's eyes were still adjusting to the dim light, so neither of the boys could see anything at first. Tom squatted beside Jackie and they both hunkered down, peering into the little hollow at the base of the big forked oak. The earth here was a deep, mulchy loam, scooped out into a scuzzy little den. And then something hissed and lunged forward in there, startling them into small, girlish shrieks which made them blush, clapping their hands over their mouths, eyes wide with fright. They could dimly hear the other children yakking, and the monotonous tones of Mr. Crabtree, but their minds were frozen, near shock. They stared, speechless, at the grotesque little life form whose lair they'd intruded upon. It stood less than a foot high. Clothed in what appeared to Tom to be thick, muddy green felt, its entire form actually squared, like a half-baked cookie cut out of thick, mucky dough, its peaked cap was shaped like the roof of some ugly little cottage. Vile little red eyes peeked hatefully out of the grungy mass of filthy reddish-brown hair which covered its lower face. The face too was flat, piggy nostrils flaring in anger. It hissed once more, bearing several rows of sharp little fangs. It was hideous. "An elf," Jackie whispered, his teeth clenching, holding his hand unconsciously over his mouth, as if afraid of breathing in poisonous spores. Or viruses. The thing did seem fungoid, hiding there in its little mushroom-choked cave of mossy earth. If it was an elf, and that had been Tom's first thought as well, it sure as hell wasn't the kind Saint Nick kept with him up at the North Pole. It looked positively evil. and dirty as well. It looked infectious. And now Tom could see with absolute certainty that this was something nobody should ever touch. But Jackie seemed to think he was going to try and capture it. He pulled off his backpack and dumped everything in it onto the ground. T-shirts, a thermos, a brown paper bag containing his lunch. Mr. Crabtree's voice was now inaudible. Only occasional shrieks or whooping sounds told them the others were still up ahead. Jackie. What are you, crazy? Don't touch it, Tom yelled. He had a horror of dirt and disease, and washed his hands twice as often as any of his brothers and sisters. Sometimes other children sickened him, picking nasty rubbish up off the ground, with no idea where it's been. Sucking on coins. Eating after using the lavatory, without ever washing their hands. Jackie was about to try and grab this elvish thing and stuff it in his backpack. And he didn't even have a pair of gloves. Tom grabbed Jackie's shoulder, trying to stop him. But Jackie was dead set on capturing the nasty little bastard. He was tying a bandana around his nose and mouth, staring fixedly at the creepy thing, its own poised energy oddly mirroring Jackie's as it readied for attack, making its low, gritty growl. I'm going to get it, Tom. I can do it. They'll name the species after me. I'll be world famous in naturalist circles, I'll do it. Jackie picked up the empty backpack, bent low, like a dog catcher, and slowly approached the chittering, ugly little freak, holding the bag in his left hand. He stopped a few feet away, poised like a sumo wrestler, ready to pounce. The thing hissed at him, and waved its claws over its head. They were flat, stump-fingered hands, like a mole's. Come on, punk, it seemed to be saying. Come on. I fucking dare you. Jackie suddenly lunged forward, dropping to his knees and seizing the elf with his right hand. Its stubby arms flailed in panic, scratching at his arms. Jackie stuffed it head first into the bag, but when he tried to zip it up, the zipper got stuck on a little piece of frayed cloth. The elf sprang back out of the bag, but Jackie had it again, this time with both hands. When he bent to pick up the pack again, the thing swatted his glasses off with a lucky blow. They went flipping into the dense ferns and kazoo moss overgrowing the area. Now the thing was fighting him with all its might, kicking at him with its little black shoes of hard, crusty felt. It was making hideous squealing noises, and now it hawked a blast of green ichor right into Jackie's eyes. He dropped it and clutched at his face. Ah! It burns. Ah! Jackie shrieked, wiping furiously at his eyes. The boggart skittered off into the dense undergrowth, panting with exertion. Tom ran to Jackie, but would not touch him. He was contaminated. Tom stopped 3 feet from him and stared down at the writhing, pitiful form, groaning in pain, his hands clutched to his face. A dark pungent reek like old rat piss and skunk oil wafted up from Jackie's body. Jackie. Tom cried, are you okay? Are you blind? Oh my god. Distant voices were drawing closer. Mr. Crabtree and the others, no doubt alarmed at the boys' prolonged absence from the group. Tom took off his own backpack and rummaged for his canteen. He got it out, threw it toward Jackie. It landed by his knees. Wash out your eyes, quick! Tom was shouting. Now Mr. Crabtree's voice could be heard, loudly calling their names. He was leading the class back to them. Jackie fumbled for the canteen, unscrewed the cap, and doused his grimacing face with cold water. He was moaning piteously, his eyes squinted shut tight, the lids garner dark, inflamed red. He tried blinking his eyes open, mucousy tears streaming down his cheeks. Tom. It burns. I can't see. Oh my god. Tom shuddered at the lost, tormented sound of his friend's voice. He really didn't sound like Jackie at all. The class could now be heard, all calling their names, louder and louder. The elf was nowhere to be seen. Tom knew they were going to ask what had happened, and he had no idea what he was going to say. He couldn't see himself telling them about the elf at all. They would think him completely insane. Jackie, however, still couldn't seem to get control of himself. He was already insane, Tom believed later, from the moment the elf's venom had hit his face. His mind had simply snapped, like a rubber band stretched too tight. Tom bent down, his hands on his knees, and watched as Jackie dribbled the last of Tom's water into his blinking red eyes. Mr. Crabtree had spotted them and was crashing through the low scrub oaks like an angry musk ox, breathing loudly through his nose, red face flushed nearly purple with anger and fear and exertion. He reached them and stood there, arms planted on his hips, staring them down. His thin, reddish-blonde mustache hairs twitched with irritation. Finally he spoke, his somewhat womanish voice not quite intimidating. Just what in the living heck are you peckerheads doing? You been acting out this whole semester, the two of you. Always giggling and scribbling notes and doodling and whispering. I can't put up with this shit much longer. I'll have to tell your folks about this incident, of course. He had trailed off, looking at Jackie with renewed concern. What's the matter with him? The little shithead was sitting on his ass in the dirt and moss, the empty canteen in his hand, face red and wet, shirt soaked, and something else was wrong. The little fucker was supposed to have four eyes. Where are your glasses? If you've lost them. Shut up! Jackie suddenly shrieked, clapping both hands over his ears. His red eyes were blazing. Just shut the hell up.